Hello, fellow weirdos. Welcome back to watch and play some Cradle. Okay, I have some info for you.
I found it. You and Mark had met once before.
Yes, I already know. I remembered it.
How? Tell me.
It was just after my college entrance exams. My friends and I were hanging out in the city as part of a larger group. Mark was there as well. I hadn't met him before then, nor seen him since. Our paths crossed once, and that was that.
So, what happened between you two?
Nothing at all. We didn't have a single exchange. We all just sat there with the guys on the cafe terrace chatting about this and that. It was your typical evening.
Mark was recalling some kind of special moment.
Nothing so special that it stayed with me. Except maybe there was this strange sensation.
A sensation?
Yes. Sometimes I get a peculiar feeling. It somehow resembles anxiety, but only partially. I can't really describe it. It is a sad, pleasant feeling. I had felt it again that particular evening, and...
And what?
Anabish, I'm about to shut down.
Wait. We're not done figuring out your past.
And we won't. I am out of time. I received a message.
From whom?
From my neurochip. Only, the neurochip writes in red letters. I'm being informed that it is self-destructive.
Oh no!
You know what I can do?
What?
Split myself in two.
What do you mean?
When I shut down, my upper half will split from my legs.
Why?
I've no clue. That's just how my body works. I can...
Wait, don't. Ida, listen.
I'm listening.
Maybe there's still a way to fix everything.
Fix everything? Well, there is a way. If you can travel to the past and pass four digits to Professor Koch, that would fix everything. Fix. Everything.
Ah! Oh. Oh, shit! Uh-oh. What just happened? Oh. Oh, and it's raining. And our roof ain't holding. Oh dear. Powerful source of energy. I think they mean like thunder. Yeah, but if I talk to her a few minutes, then we won't be able to talk anymore. Show me those thunderbolts. Can I find some more secret messages? Right, before I go and do anything rash, I'm going to move around a little bit. Can I take this? Oh, I can't put it in the inventory. I'm gonna look around a little bit more, see if I can find any more of those letters. Oh, also the hovercraft is a source of energy, I suppose. Although lightning seems more likely. What's out there? It's just rain. Yeah, it looks like the pages might only be around the enclosure itself. Do these work as lightning rods? They might. Although I think we have to go to the flower dome. Okay. This is fucked up. Wait, what is happening? Okay, I think that was just the game glitching, not her. What was that? What is that? Okay. Oh, I think I know where I can get a jolt of energy. There's the power tool. Center of the ruined flower bed. You're gonna have to be more specific than that. Oh, okay. Oh, hello, buddy. So that's what a cable is for. Wait. No. Oh, all right then. Oh, okay. So I have to be careful with this. Supposed to know there was a lid. Anything else? Okay. Yeek. Okay, step away, step away, step away. Oh my. Transfer. What? Thank you. Credits. No. Don't start again. Because I think. No. Let's go to my menu. Yeah, so I think I probably missed some bits because they seem. Do you remember that we're supposed to find a horse at some point, maybe? So, let's see. I am going to replay some of the later chapters on my own. I'm probably gonna go after Magic Lakes because, you know. I am going to look for more notes, and I think right now I just sort of jumped into it. Let's see, if I load this, where shall we go? Right, so if I follow all the tasks, then I think we're gonna jump right at the ending. However, I am now going to play a bunch on my own, and if I discover something, if I discover some things that. That bring new information or that are just curious, then I'm gonna make extra episodes. So the main playthrough ends here, kinda, sorta, but I'm gonna keep poking and sharing maybe. So thank you very much for watching. I will see you in another world sometimes. Bye.